Hello there. Matt Hancock should either resign or be sacked, but Boris Johnson just waves the matter aside. As per usual, please like, subscribe, and comment below. So the Health Secretary, Matt Hancock, is caught on Westminster CCTV giving one of his aides, Gina Coladangelo, a very intimate snogging hug, and no action will ensue. Matt Hancock calls it a breach of social distancing rules, but it looked more to me like he was doing an impression of one of those hideous face-sucking things on the film Alien. And The Sun says this happened on the 6th of May, and puts it all like this. Health Secretary Matt Hancock has been having a secret affair with a close friend and aide. He cheated on his wife with Gina Coladangelo, 43, who he hired last year with taxpayers' money as COVID gripped Britain. He was seen kissing her at the Department of Health's London HQ during office hours last month as the mutant strain began spreading. And the report went on to quote a Westminster whistleblower saying that it was shocking that Mr. Hancock was having an affair in the middle of a pandemic with an advisor and friend he used public money to hire. So why isn't Hancock doing an exit from his office carrying a cardboard box containing his personal effects? Because here we have someone central to dictating social distancing rules and imposing them on the rest of us under pain of large fines, etc., who then goes on to flout the lot of them. But right now we're witnessing the rich and powerful openly ignoring the rules, think G7, or worse, having the rules rewritten for their own benefit, think Euro Soccer 2021. Then also consider that over the last few years we've had reports of service personnel being sacked for engaging in affairs. Now you could try and argue that it's different for the armed forces, but politicians are the ones that make the rules for them as well. And the ministerial code does say that relations with work colleagues should be proper and appropriate. And where service people are concerned, those sackings almost certainly mean curtains for their careers. No chance of a Peter Mandelson-type career revival for them. Anyway, Matt Hancock has apologised for creating Hand-On Cockgate, although whose hand it was. Anyway, The Sun quotes a friend of Hancock saying that he has no comment on personal matters. No rules have been broken. Apart from lockdown social distancing rules, maybe? And in his statement, Hancock did say, I accept that I breached the social distancing guidance in these circumstances. I have let people down and I am very sorry. I remain focused on working to get the country out of this pandemic and would be grateful for privacy for my family on this personal matter. So he's hung his head in shame and said he's very sorry, but he'll still be back in his office on Monday. Wonder if the camera's still there. Say cheese, Mr. Hancock. But Grant Shapps intervening to say that Hancock's aide Gina would have been subjected to an incredibly rigorous recruitment process probably wasn't helpful. Now, going back a bit, last year Hancock was asked about Neil, Professor Lockdown Ferguson, disregarding social distancing rules to meet his married mistress during lockdown. And back then Hancock said the rules are there for everyone and were incredibly serious, etc. Serious for other people, obviously. But now we find that the PM, Boris Johnson, has accepted Hancock's apology and considers the matter closed. So Hancock stays then. What's that old adage? If you want to get something done, then ask a busy person to do it. So the PM might be thinking along those lines, because his health secretary does appear to be the busiest person on the job. But one does wonder whether it was Hancock's half hour or Hancock's 10 seconds, because that image doing the rounds is reportedly a still from video footage. So where's the rest of the reel then? On sale in shops in red light districts around the world, maybe? The government security group has been asked to look into this matter. But there are now calls for MI5 to investigate whether foreign actors were involved in the leak of security video footage from Hancock's office. But the really big question is, did Hancock know the camera was there? If he was aware of its presence, then it shows an epic scale of arrogance. But if he didn't, then you have to wonder how many ministers are now feeling the clammy, cold fingers of fate running up their spines. But then there's the really critical question of whether it really was footage from a security camera. Because the Telegraph reports that insiders are saying it is unheard of for security cameras to be placed inside the offices of a Secretary of State. So who or what organisation did put it there, and for what purpose? Blackmail, maybe? Was it an employee or contractor on the make? Or some Russian super spy? Or even MI5 themselves keeping tabs on the busy health secretary? If this is the scenario, then whoever it was had the ability to get inside with a camera, place it in a covert position, then recover it or the limited internal memory, possibly at regular intervals, or worse still, to be in an external location and have the ability to receive a constant stream output from that camera. The plot thickens. But at least those on social media had a hoot over it. One pointed to a recent Instagram post by Matt Hancock where he says, "I work alongside some brilliant women. If you're a woman who wants to get involved in politics, swipe up." And someone on Twitter said the Health Secretary's pandemic procedure was obviously hands, face, embrace, or hands, face, back to my place. Now I wonder what important political shenanigans is being missed while everyone, myself included, concentrates on this story. So what's your opinion on Matt Hancock's position? Please like and comment below. Please subscribe and like this video, buy a mug and support me on Patreon or PayPal, and thank you for watching.